Hello everyone, welcome to a new legacy video. I finally made the big move, the big step, and purchased 4 Vreden 6 to make all the legacy video that you will ever need. You might say, Vreden 6 is still bad, oppress the format, and blah blah blah. I think this card is great, it's very fun to play with, and it just makes all the fair strategies a little bit better. This is very bad against combo, so you have, and it enables decks like this. What is this deck? This is called Jund. The colors are Jund, but I didn't know how to call this deck because there's not really a name for it. I just called Jund MatSole, which is the trophy leader who happens to play this deck a lot. I play against him, this person, one or two times, and they were playing always this kind of deck, which is weird. Alright, this deck is playing 25 lands. 4 Mox Diamond. If you just want to go Vreden 6 on turn 1, then just get back lands and gain the value. You just play 4 Chalice and 4 Trinisphere. You even have Abyss Reclaimer to just get your toolbox land. You can, because Evorad Stronghold, Ghost Quarter, Caracas, Wasteland, of course. And you also have Ancient Tomb, because you are also playing Greenstone Zenith. Greenstone Zenith package, you have a lot of weird creature like Antmaster of the Fells, Moraine Clan of Thoth, Titania. So this, I could have called this Jund Fit, Nick Fit, but I think a Nick Fit kind of relies on Veteran Explorer. So like Huntmaster, Moraine, Titania, Course of Crucifix, Starless Tracker, Reclamation Sage, Ramon of Excavator, and Scavenging Goose, and Abyss Reclaimer, and of course Dread Arbor. 4 Abrupt Decay, no Assassin's Trophy, because we want to destroy opponents and we don't want to give them lands. 2 Lithium Library, 4 Vreden 6. So yeah, this deck is cool and I really can't wait to play it. So we have 4 Ley Line, 2 Play Engineer, 2 Toxic Deluge, 3 Choke, 1 Tsunami, just the package against blue decks. Collector Oofy, which you can tutor it. Then Obelisk Spider, which is a card from Howard Devastation that is a blocker for her. It's basically just a blocker. It's a fine removal spell, but mainly just a blocker for Delver of Secrets. And then Maelstrom Pulse for like Jace Demise Sculpture and such. And yep, that's the deck. Can't wait to play this. So let's head down to a competitive Legacy League. But before that, I remind you that this is ChannelFireball.com and you can support me and Channel Fireball by purchasing cards from Channel Fireball using the link that you can find in the description of this video. So yeah, let's go. Round number 1 on the play. Let's go. Both of us keep 7, which is pretty unlikely in Legacy these days. A lot of mulligans going on. Alright, opponent is also on the Mox Diamond Brand 6 package. Oh, on lands. Okay. That's a good start, opponent. That is a very good start. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay, let's get this Dread Arbor out. I don't have that many other plays here. Wastelanding, it's not appealing, but I do have Ramona plus Wasteland in case it works. Opponent does have Bushukabog in the graveyard, so we might sequence them in a way where our opponent's one card in hand. If they have a crop rotation, I'm dead. They do have Caracas here. Alright, it's tapped. Alright, so what do you want to do here? If they have crop rotation, they can crop rotation this away, but I still need, and they also have 2 mana. This is tricky now. Because I don't really, maybe I can go Wasteland on the Dark Depths. But I can also just go Caracas. If I go Caracas go, how does it feel like? I think it's good, right? If I go Caracas go, instead of going Wasteland on the Dark Depths, and then like they might tap my Caracas in upkeep. Because if I go Wasteland, maybe in their upkeep I can Wasteland the Dark Depths. They don't have, at this point I kinda think for sure that they don't have a Life from the Loam, right? So I think Wasteland can actually be a good play here instead of Caracas. Yeah. I think I'll do that. So I go Wasteland Pass, and then in upkeep, I'll go Wasteland the Dark Depths, so that I'd even stop them from drawing Thespian Stage. Right. If they have a crop rotation and they want to make a 20/20, they can, but then I have Caracas in my turn. So it was very important to, I think, sequence the cards in this way. Alright, they pass the turn with 2 cards in hand. What do they have? They can't really have much. Maybe just Glash Out Chasm and, like, I don't know. Sure, that gets tapped to draw a card. Mox Diamond. Alright, so let's play Mox Diamond. I'll discard Evorad Stronghold. Then I'll play Caracas. And then I think I want to play, I already played made the land drop, I could play Zenith 4 too to get an ooze. Or I can even take Elvish Reclaimer. I think I already have Ramon Up Wasteland going, so I don't need much. So I think I'll go for ooze here. I think ooze is very important against them. So they definitely don't have Punishing Fire, or they would have killed my Dried Arbor and then tapped my four. So they definitely don't have that. So once the ooze gets rolling, I can just exile like their graveyard in case they draw like Loam. If they draw Loam now, or they draw a Shadow Port, and they pass. So in upkeep, whenever they tap a green mana, I can use the ooze now. They tap Caracas, so I can't use that. And do they tap something else? Probably, right? Because now I can play Abrupt Decay on the Mox Diamond, but I don't think I want to do that. I'd rather just exile the Dark Depths and draw a card. Could have exiled the Bajuka Bog because if they draw a... Alright, so let's play Loam. Sorry, let's play Small Library and attack for two. Alright, so now they can tap two of my lands. They can still, if I draw a land with the Small Library, which is likely, I can get the Ramon Up Excavator down. Ghost Quarter, alright, I have plenty of basics in my deck. So much better that than Wasteland. They play a lot of these effects, because they must play for Wasteland, so they have Port, Wasteland, and Ghost Quarter, that's a lot. Alright, let's exile the last land in the graveyard. I did tap the Outer Forest, so I could play Abrupt Decay, but I'd rather not, because I want to hit a land with a library to play the Ramon Up Excavator. Round 6, I can't cast that. Alright. Pretty unfortunate here. I think I'll lose 8 life here. I don't need all these lands. I don't need all these... Alright, 2 Silver Library. Do I want to play 2 Silver Library or just want to pass? I think I just want to pass here. 2 Silver Library doesn't do anything. They don't stack. If you have 2 in play, it's like if you have 1. I'm playing 2 in this deck, but... You know, at some point I even saw playing more than 2. It's pretty weird. Alright, they go Crop Rotation. Sure. What do they get? Blast Zone. Alright. Pop the Blast Zone up to 2, and then they can blow up the Ooze and the Library. Okay. There's nothing I can do about it, unfortunately. Really wish I'd draw land. Yeah, if I draw land, I can play Ramon Up Excavator. The game goes pretty well. Alright, they have 0 cards in hand. Maybe they had the Crop Rotation, who knows. Okay, so they blow up that. Gonna exile the Blast Zone. And they blow up the 2 of my permanents. Alright. We have 25 lands in this deck, so it's pretty unlikely to miss land, but they definitely play more than us. Alright, so that's tapped. Now I definitely don't want to play Abrupt Decay on anything, because even if I miss land drop, I can still play Silver Library here. Alright. Thespian Stage. Mm-hmm. So they can have another Rishad on port. So it's mandatory that I hit a land drop now. It's mandatory. If I miss now, I could just lose the game, but it's so unlikely to miss. I mean, see 3 cards. Come on. Alright, so I'll put this on top, and then I'll definitely pay 4 here, because I can go Mox Diamond, hit the Ghost Quarter, then I can go Ramon Up Excavator, or I can go Renin 6. I already have to make a land, sorry, I have to make a land drop yet, so I think I try to just go Ramon Up Excavator, and then just wasteland the Thespian Stage, wait, we shut on port when they copy. I think Ramon Up Excavator is better. Because the Vren 6 costs only 2, this one costs 3. So get a Wasteland down and pass the turn. Alright, now hopefully I can just destroy all my opponent lands one at a time. They don't copy anything with the Thespian Stage, which is weird. Even if they draw Crop Rotation, they can 2020, because I'm going to Wasteland the Thespian Stage now. Maybe even the port. Maybe I can even Wasteland the port. Ooh, Ghost Quarter. It's a bold play. Alright, let's Wasteland what, the port? Maybe just the Thespian Stage, yeah? Alright. Maybe just a test pin stage. Alright, what did I do here? Oh, that's so bad. How did I not see this line? My apologies. So basically what happened here is that test pin stage can copy a land. So they copied a basic and they fizzled my wasteland. So that was what happened. I should have just destroyed a port. Alright. Okay, so they can't tap the Dread Arbor. I kind of just want to explode this, sorry, destroy the exploration now, so that the loam is not that good. I do have Reclamation Sage to do that, though. I think it's fine. I'll just use my mana better. Alright, so, mistake on my side, and let's continue the game. Drop Property Key. Chalice. So I can put Chalice on 2. So yeah, I'm gonna do that. Alright, let's put into play a Wasteland. Let's play Chalice on 2. Which will stop my Brandon 6, but it will also stop the Loam, which is like one of the most important things. Lands deck plays very bad with Chalice on 2 in play. I remember that from the time I was playing Lands. Because they have a lot of 2 draws, Punishing Fire, Brandon 6, Life from the Loam. And they do have this Caracas into play now. And opponent can't really play around it very easily. I mean, they can't play around both my Wasteland and my Caracas. I guess they can, like, top deck Tespian. Nah, they can't. They have to top deck, like, Crop Rotation. And then maybe they can set me a trap. They concede, though. Alright, your Grinder wins. This is a good game because, like, we showed the mistake that you know, it's not that obvious. I haven't been played against Tespian Stage 4 in a long time, so I just forgot about it, but yeah. And we also showed the power of Chalice on 2, it just made my opponent concede here. Had they drawn a Crop Rotation, maybe they could have got it out a little bit, because they can just tap my Caracas in upkeep, and then just and just go squirt in my Wasteland, and then copy the Tespian Stage, but they were kind of off of it, so we'll go. Especially because this game, I could have just wastelanded like the all the ports in 2 turns. All right, so playing against the lands, definitely got one the ley lines. Collector Ophi, it's pretty bad against Mox Diamonds. So I don't want to sideboard it in. What do we want to cut? I think all these creatures do their things. Maybe just cut some Abrupt Decays. Abrupt Decay does kill Exploration, though. So, why do I want a Maelstrom Pulse? Maybe they... Yeah, actually Abrupt Decay is good, because they have Brandon 6 in their deck. So I guess I am not going to put it in. We just got Trainosphere's. I mean, I understand that Trainosphere could be appealing, but my opponent has a lot of lands. And like, it's kind of a mirror match. I don't really want to have a Trainosphere in this deck. I just have Leyline. All right, let's go with this. Game number 2, and we open the hand with Leyline of the Void. So let's put it into play. My opponent could have plenty of ways to deal with it. Gonna kick things off with a Dread Arbor, and then we'll see what else. Alright, remember, not the Smoke Diamond is pure card disadvantage. Alright, maybe they have Sunset's Trophy? I don't know. Alright, that's a good draw. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna go for Zenith for Dried Arbor so I can go turn 2 Reclamation Sage on the Mox Diamond. Because Mox Diamond is playable in Magic in general, because you can use the lands that you discard, otherwise it's like very bad card. Like you don't, I really hate it in a cube unless you have like Wheel of Fortune kind of decks. So when Land Void isn't played, Mox Diamond gets really, really worse. So if we just kill it, it's like a pure 2-for-1. Whereas sometimes opponent could just get back the land or whatever. Okay, maybe they wasteland me, or maybe not. Alright, that's good here. I think I want to just go Reclamation Sage on the Mox Diamond. And I use the Vora Stronghold because it's kind of the weaker land here. So I go Rex Sage, kill the Mox, and pass the turn. Or do you do Crozen Grip? All right. Yes. Still good. Still good enough. What's next? Tireless Trucker. All right, now it's time to take a look at my deck. I can get three drops, so I can get, well, definitely want to get Antmaster, because that can kill. Actually, it doesn't really kill the... So, what do we want to get here? I can get Curse of Crucifix, that's good. I can get my own Tireless Trucker, that's also pretty good. Especially with this many fetch land. Yeah, I guess. Let's go for it. It could have a Punishing Fire, though. It couldn't punish me that way. But, yeah, maybe just Cursor of Crucifix is better. I guess I have Warbreath Stronghold, but I can Wasteland it. It's tough. It's very tough. I think I'm actually going for something else, because I can just take Tracker next turn with a Fetchland right away. Take Roundup Excavator. I guess Roundup Excavator is the best here. Yeah. Just because I have Wasteland down. I think I'm keeping the fetch land, though. I'll show my opponent that I have a Wasteland for the Excavator. But I think I want to keep the fetch land so that I can go with like both Titania and Tireless Trucker. And what's called? Ooh. All right. They have the 2020. So I need to draw something now or I die. And I can't take Hellish Reclaimer, but that takes so too long. I'm on 21, though. Oof. All right, being on 21 means that... Okay, check this out, guys. Being on 21 means that I can get Hellish Reclaimer, get attack down to 1, and then tutor my Caracas. Take first land, so shall be for a land, and put it on the battlefield tapped. So that is a way out here. So I'm going to Wasteland the Grove, I think. Yeah, I'm going to whistle on the Grove, so the deck can't burn me out. I'll replay Wasteland from the graveyard. I'll whistle on the Wasteland. Yes, and then I'll take the Elvish Reclaimer. Maybe there was another line. Maybe there was another line, but this is the line that I saw. So I'll stick to it. So opponent puts me down to 1, which means that I can't fetch anymore. But I will be able to... Is opponent play tapped or untapped? Oh, tapped. Oh no, so I made a mistake here. Is there another line that would have made me maybe able to win this game? No, alright. Guess it wasn't. Guess there wasn't. So is that just top deck in Caracas now? Is that it? Yeah, such a topped. Yeah, I don't think there's anything. I'm just looking at my deck, trying to focus on what can answer the thing, but I don't think there is anything. Yeah, these spiders in the sideboard. Yeah, so what I'm doing here is just use this in upkeep, trying to just thin my deck to draw that Caracas. It's my only out. One out and one only. One Caracas. I don't even play Crop Rotation to get it. Rightfully so, because I play Chalice of the Void. Which is very good in this matchup. On to our opponent. Mm-hmm, sure. Yeah, I'll have 6. Yep. I mean, nothing really matters here. All right, let's thin my deck. Definitely don't get the Caracas, just anything else. I don't want to get Ghost Quarter because I show my opponent. It's so unlikely that I do something here, so I just get a Taiga. All right, top deck. Caracas. Drop decay. Good game. Maybe there was a line, I didn't see it, though. So let's continue this, and yep, I think I really like this sideboarding. My opponent managed to beat Leyline, plus like a pretty reasonable draw. But yeah, Plague Engineer looks fine, looks not fine, and yep, let's go with this. Alright, game number 3. Sure, let's keep this hand. So I could go Chalice on one on turn one, which I think it's fine. It will stop a lot of my opponent's cards, namely Exploration and Crop Rotation. And sure, I do not play Brandon 6 on turn 2, but it's not really that I'm that worried about it. And post sideboard, opponent is slightly better against Chalice because of Crozen Grip. So I think making it on 2, it's just it takes a little bit longer. So I think I'm fine with this. I have a Miranda in my hand, which is pretty slow. Alright, let's pass the turn. Just a pretty expensive, Eternal Witness. Alright, get their basic out. We have Ghost Quarter in our deck. Opponent doesn't know about it, though. Instead of Brandon 6, Silver Library. So I think I kind of just want to kill the Silver Library here instead of playing my Brandon 6. Rimox Diamond. I think I'd rather not play Mox Diamond now. I don't have anything to do with it, so I'm just gonna slow roll it. Take a bad land, then I'll abrupt decay this. Alright. I love here to play non-basic lands, because if opponent wants to wasteland me, I'm happy because I have Brandon 6. So it's one of those games where I'm fine if opponent wastelands me. Right, Thespian Stage. This time I'm not going to wasteland it. Alright, they go Loam on, what was it? Windswept Teeth. Okay, that's fine. Wasteland. Alright. So let's go Brandon 6. Let's go Wasteland, Wasteland. I'm fine here in doing that. Opponent can't play. Opponent can't play Crop Rotation because they're. Did I make a land drop? All right, that was bad. For some reason, I thought I had to make two land. All right, sorry for that. I'll pass the turn. It's okay. Still happy with this play. I should have definitely killed the Thespian Stage, but it's also fine. So they chose not to dredge the Loam. And what is that? Okay. All right. I play Chalice. I draw Chalice. You could play on 2. So the tracker cannot kill the Varan, but they do have Varan to block it. So I think I'm gonna go basically just a defensive Varan here instead of going for Chalice on 2. Take the Thespian Stage out. Get back Wasteland. And I'll pass. Alright, keep on not dredging. I guess they have a Left from the Loam in hand, but me Ghost Quartering, sorry, Wastelanding here, it's still fine because I still keep my opponent back and they can't play Exploration. I do have 4 Abrupt Decay to deal with that Tracker. Okay, they have Mox Diamond, so that helps. They have 2 cards now. Now they can crack 2 clues, which is pretty bad actually. So they'll kill my Varan unless they want to chum block. Do I want to chum block? I guess I chum block. All right, need to draw. Just Abrupt Decay. If I draw Abrupt Decay, I'm in a good spot. Remember, you can draw Abrupt Decay even through Chalice because it's uncounterable. So a chum blocker, draw, there it is. All right, very nice. So I'll go Abrupt Decay on the tracker. Actually, I don't need to do that, I guess I do. This way my opponent can't, then I think I'll just go for, so I'll take back, yeah, whatever. I'll discard a Wasteland, then I'll return it. And then I'll play a Chalice of the Void for 2. Alright, this turn was amazing. Drawing the Abrupt Decay exactly when I needed it. Now, Brandon 6 can threaten the emblem. My opponent does not have access to Left from the Loam anymore. Because we have both Chalice on 1 and 2. They have five cards in their hand, though. Hopefully, there's a bunch of one and two drops. I can now board Stronghold the Moran back. Just not to play board Stronghold. That's weird. Basically, what happened was that I wanted to double Wasteland next turn because I have Wasteland in play this turn, so I can go Wasteland, get it back, Wasteland. That's why I chose to play Wasteland over board Stronghold. I think I'll. What do we draw? Ooh. All right. Okay, let's kick things off by Wastelanding. Because Taiga. Play Ramen Up. Cost 3, so I can cast it. Play Wasteland. Wasteland. Now I get back. Well, Wasteland. See if they drop a Juka Bog. Alright, so a lot of disruption from my opponent. It's pretty funny how we are disrupting the deck with the Left from the Loan these games. But I think that will work. Alright, we win the game. Nice. Yeah, very very clutch Abrupt Decay before opponent could take the game over with Tireless Tracker. Alright, nice win to start the day. And let's be back for round number 2. Alright, on the draw again with a pretty medium hand. Turn 1, cycle. Not great. I actually can't even cast Ren, so maybe just have to turn 1 Tranquil Ticket here. Very close. I don't know. Opponent's Mulliganing. 2-5 currently. Mulligan 2-5. I don't know. My hands kind of feel like not a very good Legacy hand. But maybe. Maybe it's good enough. Alright, opponent Mulligan's 2-5. Definitely bad against this combo. But do I play Bujuka Bog? I don't, right? That's weird. Alright, opponent name is Eldrazi with Cavern of Souls, and wow, that's great. Basically, like, they mulligan to 3 here, because they use the Simeon's Parade Guide and the Chalice. I mean, I guess I did draw Abyss Reclaimer, so there's that. But... the Charge Blade Ticket is weird though, because now I can't recur it with my Brethren 6. So maybe that was a mistake. But I really wanted to not to be able to play Brethren 6 on turn 2 and not expose a... Whoa. This is a good play. Kind of also why, you know, maybe this kind of decks are a little bit pushed out of the format these days because of Ren and 6. So we go boom. So we already had a very large card advantage in this game, and we also just remove a creature with a Ren to play. Play a 2-2 this time, though. All right. And I'll draw a card. And probably just play this 2-4, which will stonewall their 2-2. Get that back. Let's play a fetch land. Let's crack it. Let's get a whatever Bayou. I didn't play. No, I don't care to play. What is called Reclamation Sage on the Chalice. Ah, this game is super over. This game is super over. But I mean, again, opponent. Oh, maybe the Gathon's here now. No, they go Moderate Shift. I have 0 cards in hand. Land from the top, sure. All the ways to gain card advantage in this game. Can play Zenith for whatever I want, but I'd rather just, I don't know. I'd rather not. Okay, so let's crack a fetch land. Get out of land. Let's play this. Kill that. Let's play Abyss Reclaimer. Let's get back one with the fetch lands and pass. All right, if they play Thanatos here, they can take my Zenith, but they don't, and they concede the game, which was indeed very over. All right, so I want Toxic Deluge, Plague Engineer, which can name Eldrazi and then block because it's Death Touch, and Mass Trumples, a sideboard of the Chalices of the Void, and guess Obelisk Spider is better than Trinisphere. What about Collector Oofy? Maybe it is good as well. I mean, I have Trinisphere that are really bad. I would literally put anything in the deck that's better than a Trinisphere. So, I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking about what to... if, like, Chalice, Trinisphere, or Leyline are better. I can't think of anything, so I'll just keep a Trinisphere and hope not to draw it. Alright, I don't feel like I want to keep this hand. And I'll keep this. Ooh, look at this Trainosphere, how beautiful it is. Kind of feel like I did a mulligan, you know? They also mulligan in because it's on brand for them. After mulligan to 5 game 1, they're mulligan into 4 game 2. So yeah, probably the most unlucky players ever, but that is the LA line. So there's that. I have no ways to deal with that LA line. I guess I have Reclamation Sage. Do they have a land though? They do. Nice. And they pass. Taiga. I'll play Taiga, why not? Alright. So we don't have much going on, but I'll put it also mulligan to 4 to find that ley line. I play Thonnetseer now. Yeah, after mulligan to 4, you do a Thonnetseer turn 2 very likely. Okay, so they take my Toxic Deluge, and yeah, sure, I can't lose this game at this point. Because I didn't have the day also mulligan to 4, because this 2 max diamond don't do anything with this ley line in play, so it's kind of feel like a mulligan to 4 mirror match, you know? We need to draw good cards here. I could ramp thanks to Smoke's Diamond, but I need to draw them the good cards, like that Titania. She doesn't do too much. It's actually a 5 mana, 5-3, no abilities. Pretty bad. I could play Ancient Tomb and Titania, 5-3, just to block. Why not, right? I guess the reason why I don't want to is that I don't want to shock myself so many times with the Ancient Tomb. But I also have a lot of mana, so I think I will go for that, yeah. So Smoke's Diamond. So yeah, I'll play my 5 mana, 5-3, no abilities. Literally no abilities, because of Leyline of the Void. But at least I save my life, you know? And I do have an Ancient Tomb in play, so if I draw like a Zenith, I can get like some good 4 drops, like an Antmaster of the Fells would be very good in the spot. It's a lot, big body, and yeah, I just gain some life. Alright, I got a Wasteland, so I'll lose the Ancient Tomb as well. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe they just want to play into Berengar next turn. Who knows? Alright, I drew Wasteland, so I think I want to attack here. And then I'll destroy Eldrazi Temple. I think I'm fine with this race here. It's kind of, you know, if we didn't have other, if there wasn't a ley line in play, my Titania would have been so good in this game, just returning all the lands that discarded on Diamond, making token with a fetch land, making token with a wasteland. Instead, we don't get to do anything because of ley line. Alright, Urborg, interesting. Sure, I'll continue attacking here. I'm definitely winning the race. It's 14 to 5, to 8. And they didn't have a smash last turn, so I assume they have a Endbringer in hand. That's my assumption. Why do they keep on attacking? I guess they really don't want me to draw cards, so it makes sense. No matter shipper, please. Walking Ballista 1-1. Sure. Oh, Courser of Crucifix. I'm definitely attacking here. Again, I feel like I'm way ahead in this race. I mean, not way ahead, because if I wasn't 9, I was behind. So I'm putting this to attack, but like, them putting me to 9 here, still. Very glad I didn't play Ancient Tomb, because like even if I don't hit the land off the top of my deck, I can still gain a life off the Ancient Tomb that I kept in my hand. Alright, Prop Decay is pretty bad, but yeah, whatever. In Texas Demox Diamond, I did not have to fetch the 2 fetch lands, so I'm still on a healthy life total. Alright, this time I can't attack. Yeah, they pass. I draw my Abrupt Decay, what's on top? It's a Trample Ticket, which I think I'll play instead of Cycling. It's the same, at the end of the day I'm just drawing a card, but I'm drawing a card now. And do I want to attack here? I think I do. I draw a Ghost Quarter, which doesn't do anything, but I think I'm attacking because, yeah. Just get my 2-for-1 now. My Titanic will keep on not doing anything the rest of the game. I don't think I have ways to deal with that. I mean, I do have, there it is. I do have ways to kill to the line of the Void with Reclamation Sage, but if I draw Zenith, I'm not gonna take Reclamation Sage. I'm taking like Antmaster of the Fells in this case. Alright, it's a 4 mana. Is that a Thonnetseer probably? Oh, Endless One. Alright, that's perfect for my Abrupt Decay end of turn. Alright. Strong Master, Ren and 6 on top. I can add black and black and red. Do you think they have a basic land? Do you think they have a basic land? I don't, I mean, if they have to, if they have it, whatever. I'm gonna just draw step, kill the Urborg. So that if they want to tap the Ancient Tomb, they'll lose two more life. Do it in draw step, so it's more likely that they draw, if they have a waste, it's more likely that they draw it. They concede. All right, very easy. No, it's not very easy, because like, we're pulling mana to four, but still, give us a big, big hard time with this ley line. But yeah, our 5 mana, 5-3 new abilities did these things. All right, we're 2-0. Let's move for round number 3 with Jund MatSole. Again, I don't know the name of this deck. I just call it by the inventor, MatSole. And yeah, this deck's great. I'm having a lot of fun. And I remind you that this is ChannelFireball.com. And ChannelFireball.com not only sells cards, but also buys your card. You can check their pricing your cards on ChannelFireball.com/buylist. And remember that there's a 30% store credit bonus if you want to trade. Third match on the draw in a row, playing as JPA, the combo master, so it's not good. It's not good to be on the draw against the combo master. Alright, but this is great. I can go turn 1-3 in the sphere. Can't really get better than that. They're playing, I think, all their on brand sneak and show. And they shuffle, nice. Alright, I'll go Mox Diamond, discard Swamp, then I'll play Trinisphere, hoping it resolves. Trinisphere turn 1 is great. If it was in the play, they needed to force. Whereas now, oh, they daze me? Oh, that's bad. Okay. So, what can the Zenith get against them? A Zenith for 3, that's not much. But that's not much in general. Against the combo deck like that. I guess I can get Taros Trucker. Oh, I guess I can get a Reclamation Sage now. Ooh, Chalice. I think I draw just get Reclamation Sage. Yeah. Instead of going Chalice. Alright, I'll take a Bayou. Let's take Rex Sage. Let's open this a little bit more. Rex Sage. Kill that. See if they have a Brainstorm. And Response. Next turn I can go Titania. Bring back a 5-3. Maybe just attack for lethal. Who knows? Maybe I can play a Chalice on 0. Wait. I think I'll play a Chalice for 0. I think I will, yeah. I guess Nick and Show Chalice on 1 is not that good if it's this late. So I think it's likely that they maybe had like 1 petal. Sorry, maybe 2 petals. One they try to, one they play it and the other not. Oh no, they have show and tell. Alright, Angle will lose. Crazy brand. Alright, maybe a Drucker Rackets, who knows? Get a 5-3 into play. Maybe a Drucker Rackets. Alright, come on, Caracas. Caracas. Trinisphere. Alright, won't be attacking, but. I want to be attacking, but I need a force on this. Or it might be, you know, I mean, they will definitely win the race because I'm also on 7-14. I didn't see that coming. Maybe they don't win the race. Oh, they lose 7 life. Interesting. They just go like show and tell for Emrakul. Maybe they'll lose the race. Maybe they can't attack here. I don't know. Maybe they were supposed to draw in response to the training sphere to find a force. Alright, let's see what happens here. They attack. So go to an 18. I can deal only 17, unfortunately. Alright, they cast Shwenta for Emrakul. Mm-hmm. Alright. Now, even if I draw Caracas, I lose, but yeah. Might as well. Master. This gives me 2 life I needed. But I'm still dying to the flyers because they have a blocker. Yeah. I can see the game. Okay, so we have all the things for the flyers. Actually, not that much in this matchup. Leyland doesn't work. Toxic Doge doesn't work. Plague Engineer doesn't work. Obvious Spider doesn't work. So just this five, and I'll cut. I don't know. So I mean, I have a lot of bad cards in my deck. I think I might just cut all the Brandon six. What about Abrupt Decay? Maybe just a mix. Mix up this five. I mean, it's a lot of bad cards. Maybe like, yeah. Let's go with this. All right, game number two. I need to be on the play last game. Maybe if I was on the play, I would have won the game. All right, this is good. We have Charge of the Void on turn one, which is supposed to be good against them. I also have Caracas in hand, which they might not play around because we only have one. Now the question is, do I want to play Zenith after? Maybe I was supposed to play Chalison on 0-2. I guess I'll play now. I think I want to slow roll this Caracas. So I'll play Chalice now and I'll pass. I want to get like a Tyrus Tracker, I think, with my Chalice. With my Zenith. So yeah, I want to maybe go Chalice. I should have gone Chalice for 1 and 0. That was a mistake. That was a mistake indeed. You're also supposed to play Chalice on. Alright. Pitch Chalice on one again in case they go like a Braid on the first. Alright, Spell Pierce. Oh, it stays. Alright, back up. Nothing going on. Oh, do I want to play Chalice on 2? Maybe, you know what, I just play Chalice on 3 next turn. It will stop a bunch of my things, but it will stop the show and tell, you know? I could have another dates, that would be bad, but... Let's see if they have it. Might have Force. Force Speech Brainstorm. Alright. Alright, Omniscience, and I lose. Because even if I bounce the Emrakul, I still lose here. Because they get an extra turn, and then with the extra turn, what happens is that they try to attack, I'll bounce. I'm just doing it just to show you how does it work. I'll bounce, and post-combat, they're replaying Emrakul. And that's how I work. And that's how I lose. Alright. Alright, I think I had a great hand, but I lost game two. With game one, if I wasn't to play, maybe I would have won. Alright, let's be back for round number four. Alright, final to play. We have a Chalice on one. Ding. I do. Keep. Very, very good. This deck has, I guess, 7 ways to ramp up mana to play Chalice. It's way less than the Bomberman deck. The Bomberman deck used to play Chalice on one literally every time. If you have it in your opener. So yeah, we have got a very good hand here. Land. Mox Diamond. Discard. Fetch. I guess I got a basic. You'll never know. These people can't wasteland you. These people. And go. Hopefully we don't play against the colorless deck. In the mirror match of Chalice of the Void decks, whoever goes first has a higher risk of just throwing away a lot of cards in order to play the Chalice. Luckily we didn't have like Seamus Braid guy like the Eldrazi guy did in the previous match. Where they were on the play, Mulligan to 5, and also had a turn 1 Chalice with the Asimic Spirit Guide. Let's not cover planes. And they pass, I guess. Alright, let's write it up. Let's get back all the lands that we lost. Hopefully, no force. Alright. I could have gone for Zenith for Dryad Arbor, but I don't feel like it. I don't want to wait. I think I already have enough lands here. I don't need to ramp up more. Still Fortune Mystic, sure. It's against the Death and Taxes, which Renna 6 is great against it. Both because it disrupts my opponent's like Wasteland package, as well as, of course, it kills a lot of their things like Tali and such. They get bought a school, sure. Top draw. Alright, so let's play this on the Master of the Fells, shall we? I'll get whatever, Badland and Bayou. To play Antmaster. So that I have a chump blocker for the Bader School, and then I can kill the Bader School with the. I can kill the Bader School with the Reclamation Sage. Or next turn, I could even just get Trucker and go Greenstone Zenith, because I return the forest. Sorry, the Vernon Catacomb, so that I can go Zenith for Trucker. And just then just draw a bunch of extra cards because they can't play Plow. Sure, they can flicker with my Chalice, but it'll take a bunch of time. So if they just pass with Bioskull up, I'll... I mean, actually flip the Huntmaster as well, just not nothing. Get a 4-4. Shoot the Stoneforge Mystic down, remember. Huntmaster Refels is any player, pass the turn without playing any spell. So I'll put him in this weird spot now because... Yeah, alright, you have Ancient Tomb, so maybe that's a different kind of deck. Maybe pause Jailer? Yeah, pause Jailer. Alright, do they get a Wolf, I guess. No, the Antmaster, wow. Okay. So they become the Monarch. I draw a card and then I look at my deck because I have a Zenith and I don't know what to take here. What to take here. So this is close. I could get Moran, but I don't think it does much. I can wait one turn to play Titania, but that could be a little bit too late. I think I just want to go for Tireless Trucker. So I'll take Tireless Trucker, then I'll return a land, play it, and crack it. I can even just pass the turn because I can get Dread Arbor. Opponent might not expect it. Should have tapped with a Wolf, that was a mistake. Should have traded Wolf for Jailer before they can go like Bader School or stuff. The emblem of Renin 6 in this deck isn't particularly good. Because we don't have that many spells. Actually, how many spells we have? Just Abrupt Decay. Which would be solid though now in this game. Because Zenith unfortunately shuffles in the deck, so it's not in my graveyard. So in this game, I can just crack a bunch of clues, make my Trucker very large. Remember, this Chalice on one, so they can't plow it. And they already use one Positator. Had I drawn Wasteland, I don't know, maybe could have just killed the Ancient Devourer. So the point is a lot of cards and a lot of decisions. I assume it has a bunch of things that they can play, like Mother of Ruins, Italia, and like, you know, X1s in general, because they've run on 6. And they have, you know, plenty of lands already. Which is pretty funny, because at the end of the day, I just drew 3 lands in this game. These 3 fetch lands. Ren 6 being very good in this game by just ramping me up mana. It's gonna be hard to get the Monarchy back. I could see, you know, us losing this game. I thought I was winning for sure, but you know, on the play with Chalice on 1, Ren on 2 against Mono White. But... Alright, so they keep on tapping the Ancient Tomb. Come on, opponent, play a little bit faster. I know it's hard though. I guess it is very hard. On them, they have 8 cards in their hand. Then they'll draw one more at the end of the turn, thanks to this Monarchy token, which it's good like this, but Magic Line doesn't show it when it's small. Trinity Sphere will also be good eventually, but I think now I think that the Tara Striker is better. Alright. What are the good draws here? I guess all the Zenith to get Titania. The Titania will definitely take over the game. Alright, I play another Stoneforge. That is a way to win the game. Also because even if I play Chalice on 2, I can just put it into play with the Stoneforge. Yeah, Mazao is just definitely good here. Alright, I'll fetch end of turn, deck thinning. Deck Taiga. Then I just have a bunch of lands left. Could have waited one turn to go for maybe play Chalice on two and then go for Titania. That's strong, but maybe I just draw land here. I just draw Zenith here. Alright, come on, good card. Wasteland. Yeah, I'll just crack a clue to start. Not a good draw. Do I want to play Chalice on two? I want a Wasteland Dam. Maybe I wasn't supposed to crack a clue, just... yeah. I don't know, this is very hard now. Also because, like, maybe I just play a tracker very large. Just, yeah, I may just... play a Wasteland. Tap the Wasteland to crack a clue. And like drop Rap Decay. Alright, I did. Very nice. That is classic game where, you know, you play for your outs and you draw them, you'll feel very, very happy. So now I'll pause the turn with this Abrupt Decay in my hand. I could actually just attack with a tracker, but that would just play a 4-4 and block, so. And then I have to craft a clue. Instead, I want to play Abrupt Decay on Doomazawa's Jit. So Rhinoceros is on 7. Next turn, I can start killing a bunch of things. With the, and remember, Jit, this only bounces a creature, and Jit isn't a creature. So we pass the turn, we run over 4 Abrupt Decay there to, it's very good here. So, let's have a, yeah. Alright, putting 7 cards in hand, one of them is Umazawa's Jit. I don't know how much mana they have, but I discarded the Caracas for Ensign's last turn. And they still have to make a land drop. So now, let's say my opponent just pays 4 lands, pays 4 mana, play a Jit and a Kip. Let's say a Kip on the Germ. I think I want to just Charm Block with a Wolf. Because remember, I didn't trade the Wolf for the Jailer. And I called the mistake. But it might not be a mistake. It might be actually the right play there. And if Rand 6, I don't want to let her die for the Emblem. So we're going to keep it up. Like, unless I draw another Ren 6, then I'm fine in having the emblem with Abrupt Decay to gun down a bunch of things. Like, not only this and this, but just literally everything they have in their deck. I guess I could go Body Scorn Jailer, but yeah, that's about it. Also, we have this tracker. And remember, there's a Chalice on one. That could go Flicker Wisp. Okay, let's see. I also have but I have a backup Chalice. All right, so they got the combat. I'm going to chump block the Body Scorn here. They don't go for the Jit though, which is weird, right? So I could block with a tracker and crack a clue. I think now I want to do that, right? Yeah, I'll do that. So I'll block and I crack the clue, because now I don't really need to crack my to decay anything. Alright, so 6/5 with a damage with 4 damage on it. Sure. Wonder what's gonna happen here. 2 ancient tombs. There's so many ancient tombs. Oh, they go for walking ballista. Okay. That's fine. I did not consider display at all. Totally forgot about it, but that's fine. So I can now maybe ping the walking ballista. Alright, I pinged the Vran, so it's basically the same. It's weird. Alright, draw a card. Okay. Zenith. Interesting. So now, what can I do is go for Zenith on the Titania, and let's just make a mess. And then just make a mess. So I need to pay 6. Yeah. So I go Ancient Tomb, Zenith. So 5. Take Titania, get my land back. Then I can waste. Yeah, that's good. So I go down. I could also go Moran, but I think Titania just makes a huge value here. So we return that land. I guess I can just Wasteland, get back Wasteland. So I just gun down the Ancient Tombs. Yeah, I'll do that. So let's kill all the Wasteland. And every time I kill a Wasteland, I get a 5-3. I think it's better than killing the recruiter. Or I've already made my land drop. All right, never mind. Keep on forgetting about the land drop, all right? Luckily, I'm not playing in real. Okay, let's get a... whatever, forest. So I have a lot of 5-3s, and I played everything I could, so I'll pass the turn. All right. Very happy with this turn. I mean, having 4 Zenith and just shuffling them every time in your deck just makes so much value. So now, once again, I can emblem the Vren here. So next turn, I have 3-6. I think now it's just too much damage, too much value, too much value. Because I have one more Wasteland to play. Still have the K up for the Jit. And next turn, I can just start attacking and get the Jailer back, get the Huntmaster back, and that'll be the win. So yeah, very good game here. Opponent did have a lot of choices. They thought a lot, but I think they played very well for you know, being on the draw against a Chalice plus Varana 6. Also, their list is cool. 2 Ancient Tombs. Maybe they even have a Chalice main. Who knows? Maybe definitely Chalice sideboard. Definitely Chalice sideboard. I think in this matchup, I could even keep the Chalice of the Void here. Alright, looks like 100 Black Walker. Wow. Did not expect that. Okay. Alright, I'm not gonna play Abrupt Decay, I think. Just let him draw a card. Grayson Zenith again. Wow. So, what can I do here? So, I can get Reclamation Sage, I can get Marin. So much, so many things that I can do in this game. I mean, I would love to play Azusa in this deck. Maybe you should play one Azusa. If I go Azusa here, it's great. I can have like just 2 extra land per turn. All right, let's see. If I go Emblem of Ren and 6, I can go Abrupt Decay. Let's see if I want to attack. Because if I attack, sure, it's trade with Young Burke Walker, but like, yeah, maybe attacking here is nice. Right? Because they really need to block it all. So I can like shoot down the recruiter, Abrupt Decay on the Stoneforge Mystic, and then I have, I think I want to do that. And then I just get the Monarchy. So, but then my opponent can go Mizawa's Jit. And definitely steal the Monarchy back with the Topters. This is a very, very cool game. I wanted to Abrupt Decay this aggressively, but then, yeah, I guess I do get the Ravagers of the Fells, the Werewolf back. So I could go Grayson Zenith. So what does exactly Marin do with the experience counter? If control dies. Yeah, I think I will go this pre-combat, actually. I haven't made a land drop, so I'm gonna go for this. Get Moran down. And then we have the experience counter. If I attack with all, they need to block it all. If they want to keep the monarchy. They might also just lose the monarchy. Yeah, I think it's fine to attack with all here. I'll definitely get an experience counter on the Moran, which, you know, doesn't do much, but... Titania dies, but I'm gonna get it back in the end with the Moran. Alright. So 2 experience counter on my thing. I'm gonna leave Abrupt Decay up. Because I need to play around the Jit. So this is legendary. Alright, then let's Yeah, I guess let's kill the Caracas. The discarded one. All right, I think I've used everything, so let's get that back in hand, the Titania. I think it's also legendary, right? Yeah. Titania things. So Moran, get my Titania back in hand and passes the turn. Next turn, Titania can just start wastelanding more. So yeah, they can like keep Blood School and such, but I have this Abrupt Decay up all the game. Wow, this game has been going for 17 minutes. So many minutes. So many Titania trigger. I could have just wastelanded before attacking, I guess. That was wrong. I would have had one more elemental token. That was definitely wrong, but yeah. I don't think it matters too much now. I even get to, where's the monarchy? Oh no, they still have the monarchy. And the Master of the Fells is exiled under the monarchy. So hopefully, or monarchy, I don't remember. So hopefully next turn I get the monarchy and I'll, you know. What did they do here? Are they attack with all? Where? Ren? Sure, I'm not blocking. Ren 6 goes to 3. I mean, we have 4 Ren and 6. I keep on drawing greens and zenith, but I also have other things in my deck to draw. Alright. That's on 3. That's a Plains. And that's a Tesha. Whenever you cast an historic spell, return target creature. Sure, historic spell, huh? Alright. So opponent plays like Thalia here. Artifacts, Legends, and Saga are historic. So opponent plays like Thalia or Walking Ballista or Angerbreak Walker. They reanimate something. It's gonna cost 3 or less, right? Chalice on 0. Yeah, it's good. So the Chalice on 0, which is not dead against me because they have Lotus Petals. Sorry, most diamonds. But a reanimate, well, Recruit of the Guard. That's sweet. Yeah, opponent is going off with that Teshar. I don't have ways to kill it because Abrupt Decay only shoots down 3 drops or less. Yeah, very sweet deck on my opponent's side. They revealed Pressure Revoker. Sure. They reanimate something else. Very nice. They get that back. They have another equipment. They still have that Umezawa's Jade in the end. They don't get anything. Alright. So I think it's time to cast this Abrupt Decay, probably on the Revoker. So that Ren 6 can kill a Recruiter of the Guard and then I'll be the Monarch. Alright, Ren 6. Alright. Draw a card. All the K-Dat. Teshar, Ancestor's Apostle. Draw. Sylvan Library. Alright. Let's shoot that and attack with all. Now I'm not protected against Mazawa's Jit. Just something to be aware of. They're still blocking? Why? Why do you block? Oh yeah, they're not on board if they don't block. Didn't think about that. Alright, so we get a monarchy into life. Alright. So what are we gonna do here? Definitely wastelanding an ancient tomb. Oh wait, Titania's still in the end. Alright. I wanna play Chalice on 2 though. So do I wanna play, can I play everything? So if I play Titania, pay this 5, reanimate a land. Yes, I can't play anything. Everything. So let's pay 5. Let's play Titania. So reanimate a wasteland. Maybe a fetchland? No, wasteland's fine. No, maybe fetch. Oh, wasteland's fine. Alright, let's play Chalice on 2. And then let's wasteland. And then I'm done. I even draw a card. And I get back the tracker. It's a lot of value. Draw a card from Monarchy and draw a, and get back the tracker from the, where is it, Meren, Clan of Thoth. I only have 2 experience counters, so this Tireless Tracker can't go into play. Otherwise, it would have gone into play. So, I'm on 13. They can't cast Jit here. They can't cast Jit here. Because if they cast Jit, it gets countered. They sure do get the value from the Tesher, though. I mean, I could lose this game. I mean, I'm on 4. So if they go like Battle School, they keep on the Tesher, gain 6, up to 10. I don't know. There could be a game here. There could be a game here. I can't cast my Assume Elaborate because there's Chalice. But I really don't know many. Oh, well, it's funny. Like, Chromox is getting countered from their own Chalice. Alright, so there are a lot of choices here. They can reanimate what? A Stoneforge? A Recruiter, maybe. So they reanimate a Recruiter and then get what? I don't know. Very cool game. They're on four. Why to concede? So if they keep the bottiscle here, they have, I don't know. All right. Just had to concede. That's very good. So we put in an obelisk. And who deals combat damage to a creature? Put the player. Whatever. It's here just to be a dude here. I have a lot of things to sideboard out. Collector Oof. Toxic Tailish. Plague Engineer. Yeah, all these cards are good. Seven. Once again, I have seven. Maybe I should cut like a tsunami for a fair card. So yeah, I'll just keep it in the Train Sphere. Yeah, Chalice doesn't seem very good. Yep, let's go with this. Okay, we have a one lander, unfortunately. Otherwise, this hand would have been very good. We can take a risk and hope to draw a land in the top. Because, like, if this hand works, it's so good. Maybe I should keep this hand. Alright, let's risk it. What's magic without a little bit of risk? If I draw a land, I just go Rancis turn 1, get back land, and then I have 3 mana next turn, on turn 2, and then I have Plague Engineer, which is amazing. Basically, I have like, all the cyborg cards. Not that Collector Oof is good, because it shuts off my Mox Diamond, but everything else is. And like Collector Oof, it could be good in some scenarios. Was that Chalice on 1? Oh, Underback Walker, sure. Alright, on land, boom. Zenith, that's not that bad. I'm still gonna go Mox Diamond here. Yeah. Still gonna go Mox Diamond here. It could have been better, but. Alright, pass the turn. Hopefully, I don't go like explosive to kill my Mox, or I don't know. What can they go for? Alright, I have 3 mana. And what do you do with that? They can't put a counter on the Agarbeck Walker and have 2 mana left to play. I don't know. Or they pass. Looks like at least. Maybe they just went to go second main phase for some reason. They have some spells in second main phase? Alright. Just going to see if that's surgical or force of will. Recruiter Guard. Okay. Alright, it's not bad. This is a human. This is a construct. Plague Engineer is very good against them. They take Palace Jailer. Wow, that's very good. Alright. Verdant Catacomb is my draw. We should try it last turn, though. Okay, so what can I do here? I can cast a Cursor of Crucifix. Or I can cast Brandon 6, return to Bayou, play Bayou, pass the turn. Then they will go with they will go for Palace Jailer or my Dryad Arbor, and that'll be very bad, I think. If I go Cursor of Crucifix alternatively, if they exile it, they keep my I keep the Dryad Arbor. Which I think it's nice. This is a construct that makes stop there. Unfortunately, it's not like Monster Manta where you can shut off both both houses with this. I think I'm gonna go for Cursor of Crucifix. Get a Taiga. Get a Taiga, or maybe a Badland. Badland doesn't seem very good. Actually, it is. Yeah, I think a Badland. I'll take a Badland. So if they Wasteland, Destroyed Arbor, or the Mox Diamond, I'm still able to cast everything. All right. Take a Badland. Play Cursor of Crucifix. Pass the turn. Showing my point of what I draw, though. So it's not great in the face of... So I could have played Mox Diamond there, but, you know, just to dig deeper. Had it not made a land drop, maybe you can do it at play, but... Since, let's say there's land on top, I can go like Brand 6, get back a land, play Mox Diamond, play land from the top, and then suddenly I have ramped mana thanks to the Mox Diamond. Alright. They went for the expected Palace Chiller, which is very good in this matchup, as you saw game 1. What do they exile? Probably Cursor of Crucifix? Yeah. So I'm fine with this. Like, my play here basically just let me keep a Dryad Arbor. Draw Mox Diamond, yeah, as expected. So I can go Brandon 6, get back land, and then play Mox Diamond pass. I think I like it. Opponent can attack my Veranda 6 down, though. So you play engineer named Human, then maybe, you know, maybe it's good. Maybe it's a good play for Vren. This way, Vren and 6 makes me... So I can't really play Collector Oofy, right? It just shut off my Mux Diamond. So I play Vren and 6, I only have 2 mana left. Yeah, I think I'll play Plague Engineer and pass here. Name Human. Name Human just because they have a bunch of humans. Sure, they have Angerback Walkers, that could be annoying, but... Yeah, I mean, this game, my opponent drew fine. Like, the Pass Generator is very annoying for my deck to deal with. And I did keep a, you know, not a great hand, and, like, it happened not to shape up that well. Maybe we should have mulliganed. Maybe I could play more, because, like, the thing is that if I play Vren here, they just duck it to death. Like, I have to trade my Dread Arbor for the Recruiter of the Guards, which is, like, not a good trade. So, I think I'd rather just slow myself one more turn. Also, because if I draw a land, I can just make a land drop out of the Vren's, out of the Mox Diamond. Alright, it's very annoying. Alright. Yeah. Okay, so let's play Vren, let's get back all in, let's play Mox Diamond, and let's pass the turn, I assume. Maybe I don't want to play Mox Diamond, because I want to just play Collector Oofy at some point. So I'll just play Bayou and pass. Maybe that's better. Maybe that is better. Because the Collector Oofy stops the Angerback Walker and the Walking Ballista. And I can see a scenario where the Angerback Walker is, you know, it just becomes a problem. I don't really see myself winning this game at any point, though. Which is, you know, just my opponent has so many cards. Maybe it just takes so long and I don't know, guys. I'm gonna play it out, actually. I have time. Also, might be an interesting game. Might be an interesting game. But it's definitely a long game. That's for sure. That's for granted. It's a 5 mana Bottle Skull? What is it? If it's a Bottle Skull, I can just... Oh god, it's all Oketra. Alright, now it's not a short game anymore. Oketra is a double strike threat that whenever you cast a creature spell, you create a 4/4 Black Warrior Zombie. Alright. Okay, so let's get the Verdant Catacomb back in my hand. Let's play it. I could also just shoot something, but I think I'd rather not. Alright, let's go Maelstrom Pulse on the god and pass the turn. It will come third, and that will just very soon draw it again. So is that goes third. I play my land. I can play Mox Diamond, and... we go Elvish Reclaimer. But again, I can play Mox Diamond. Play Collector Oofy. How does that feel? I would shut down my two of my lands. That's awkward. But it's not the end of the word, I think. Except with the Brand 6, maybe I can shoot Ballista and maybe that can kill my Oofy. Yeah, I think I'll do that. I have my Brand 6 to eat land drops every turn, so I think I'm fine if I discard a land here. It's not the end. Alright, so I'll play this Collector Oofy and pass the turn. I don't want to attack into the Angerback Walker with my 2/2 Plague Engineer. So now I can think if they want to activate the Walking Ballista on my brand, but I don't think that works. Next turn, I can consider shooting off the Pass Generator and attack with both. It depends on what I do, of course, but I have Grayson Zenith now. That can take maybe even Marin. I mean, getting the experience counter is good. Actually, no, Marin doesn't work because they have Caracas. It's a close game. Alright, so the Mox Diamond are shut off from a Collector Rufi. They play Ancient Tomb, have 5 cards in hand. What is this? Sanctum Prelate. Alright, they name 2, I guess, for Punishing Fire. And Brian 6. Yep. And Simo Labra as well. And as well as a Sunset Trophy, right? It can be cast, yeah. Right, what does this do? Remove a counter from Mikael's, but it goes on with another creature you control. Alright, fine. Draw a card. Mox Diamond. Very bad draw. Alright, so I have 3 mana. 4 mana. So I can go Reclamation Sage on the Walking Ballista. And then attack. With a bunch of 2/2s. That will block with this. Make 2 topters. Yeah. Or maybe I can just kill the Sanctum Prelate with the Vran 6 and attack with the Collector Oofy to block with the Hungerback Walker, maybe. Then at that point, maybe I can shut, maybe it's better if I shut down the Walking Ballista, attack with the Oofy. Then I can use my Mox Diamond to play a huge Crimson Zenith. Yeah, I think I like that better. So yeah, let's kick things off with this. Well, minus the Walking Ballista, I can't do anything in response. That I just don't want to attack with the Plague Engineer. It's just too bad of a trade. Stuck with this only. Because it's blocking my Hungerback Walker. I'm pretty happy for the trade because I unlock my Mox Diamonds now. And I can play. What do I want to play here? They have a Oketra on top of their deck. Oketra. Literally Oketra. So I can get Moran, but I don't think I'm not that excited about it. I can get Antmaster, but I'm not that excited about it. Get Roundup Excavator. I did not make a land drop this turn. Roundup Excavator, where does that bring me anywhere, right? Yeah, fortunately, I don't have enough mana to go Titania. Titania would have been sweet. Maybe we could have raised the thing. Maybe I should just wait here. We should just wait here. Their Brand dies, though, so I don't have guaranteed land. This game is very hard. I think I'll take Antmaster and pass the turn. This game is very hard, and they have the thing on top of their deck. The very good thing on top of their deck. So I'll play this and pass. The God Eternal Oketra. It's funny how the Collector Oath did very well in this game. It didn't do anything to us, and it shut off this dude, basically. Alright, so Oketra, they're down to 4. And they can't gain life. If they have a creature, they make a zombie. Though they need to like shock down to 2 and then I can just ping them. Maybe even twice and win the game. I can't play more Vran 6s because of Sanctum Prelate. Oh, but it was on each creature? Wow, I didn't know that. Alright, that's good to do. So I lose the Vran. Sure. If they tap one more, the Antmaster can gun them down. They tap one more Ancient Tomb. Alright, I need to draw a good one. That is not. So I'll attack with a Plague Engineer to block with the Palace Jailer. So I will pass the turn, flip Antmaster, deal 2 damage to... I don't know. It doesn't really make sense why I deal 2 damage because they just remove the loyalty from this. If I target the Mikhaos, I can just Caracas it back. But if I target anything else, they can just pump it. But I guess I think it's better to just write them for sure and the Sanctum Prelate. So that if they pump with Mikhaos, that's a 3-3, but with 2 damage on it, so I can block it with a Wolf. And I can block the Palace Jailer with the Ravager of Fells. Alright, there are 2 left. They can't use the Ancient Tomb. They have 5 cards in Ando. If I play 2 spells next turn, if I draw a spell next turn, I can flip this back, and then I can shoot them. So that is my plan right now. The plan is to draw a spell, make the Rotten Master back at a 1-1, sorry, back at a 2-2, and then just pass the turn, and then just shoot them to death. Hoping they don't have a plow or, you know, interactions like that. Maybe more Palace Jailers or stuff. So that is my plan right now. Opponent just dealt himself 16 damage to the Ancient Tombs. And we just try to deal 4. That is my plan. Burn deck is sweet. Alright, what's this? If any creature, will make a 4/4 Vigilance Zombie token. Alright. Plague Hero says Death Edge. So I can just block the God Eternal Catcher. I probably will if they attack me. Because this is 5 damage with double strike, so I need to chump block it for sure. I guess I'll chump block it with Wolf, because he does double strike. So they attack with the top thirst as well. This is Trample. Alright. Ideally, my opponent plays 2 spells, forgets about the Huntmaster, and I just pass the turn and kill them. That is the dream scenario. But opponent is playing very well, I think, so I'm not expecting them to forget about the Huntmaster. So yeah, please, just play 2 spells, like Chrome Mox and a spell. Recruiter. Yeah, come on, please, play whatever you get there. Play whatever you find with that. Maybe Walking Ballista. They play Walking Ballista, okay. No, they pass, very good. Alright, I draw Replicate, but I can't cast it. Oh, that's a disaster. I was so happy because I was like, alright, it's a spell, I can cast it, and then I just flipped this. But now I think the game ends. Now the game ends. Alright. I'm just taking my time because they have 4 minutes 50 on the clock, and they need to win game 3, so I'll make them kill me. 4 mana, Walking Ballista 2/2, sure. Sure. Really wish they attacked me with a Sanctum Prelate. They do not. I'll block this. And I'll block this. Oh, yeah, the first strike. That's funny. All right. Okay. Okay. Alright. Got defeated this game. It was still close though. If I draw any spell there, maybe I win. Actually, I don't, because the Walking Ballista kills my Underback Walker. Alright, good game. Game number 3. And, yeah, I like this configuration. Maybe I want Leyline of the Void over Training Sphere, because the Leyline stops Ungerbeck Walker, so if I have to have a one draw, a one off, might as well have a Leyline. Okay, final game against this, like, very tough opponent. Alright, keeping this hand, I have turn 1 Zenith for Dryad Arbor. And then turn 2 Ryan 6. Still unsure about the Prismatic Vista over the other normal fetch lands. But that's close, I guess. Alright. So very good start for us. And we'll see. Tomic. Lands on the battlefield and lands in the graveyard can be target of spells your opponent control. That's nice. That means I can't run 6, but I guess I have Abrupt Decay in my hand, so no big deals. Like a swamp. Abrupt Decay this. And I'll safely plus 1 on this. And I could activate the Elvish Reclaimer. What am I getting though? I don't know. Really know. Yeah, I'll just attack. I don't know what to get with the Elvish Reclaimer. Could get a Wasteland, but yeah, putting us 3 basics. Ranger Captain Venus, nice. The 3-mana 3/3, you get a 1 drop and then you sacrifice it, and before the cascade is turn. Alright, go Walking Ballista. Scavenging Goose. Alright, let's start things off with a Corsair of Crucifix. And on top. Plague Engineer. Alright. Let's get that. And I think I'll play Scavenging Goose here. Bayou, whatever. And pass. I have a 3-3 to block their... Sorry, 2-4 to block their 3-3. Yeah, drawing... You know, shuffling a good spell is not great, but... So I want to kill my Vrana 6, I guess, but I have another one in hand. That's why I play 4. Is that good? Alright. So I draw that. There's an abrupt decay on top. Alright. Okay, let's see if our opponent baits us. Let's see if they block the ooze. Because I can eat the Tomic and the Dry Arbor, as I can sacrifice a land. Alright, that's nice. So I'll go for the play of sacrificing Dry Arbor and then eating the Dry Arbor and the Tomic. We'll get a, wasteland. I think it's always good to have a wasteland around. Alright, I can see the magic because they just realized that I can eat now with these two forests, the Dryad Arbor and Atomic, and I just have a very good board. Also, I can just go like Prismatic, face that Brian and 6, get back Dryad Arbor. That's an easy win. Alright, let's be back for round number 5. Last match with this super sweet deck. Alright, great hand. Great hand. Choice of the Void on turn 1 or the play. I'll put him out against the 5. 4. Xu Zheng Yu. Alright. So, play on 4 cards. Maybe they're a reanimator, whatever. And then the Chalice will hopefully just crack them. Boom. Crack them down. Maybe they are on Cloud Post. Then, you know, it's gonna be harder. Uh huh. Alright. I'm going to play Grandson Zenith for who knows. Could be Obvious Reclaimer with Rhino 6 around. It could be a Scavenging Goose, but I think I'll go for Reclaimer. Despite the Chalice on 1, the Obvious Reclaimer manages to come into play. And opponent passes. And what do we want to do here? I don't know. I'll take a Vran and then I'll pass after returning a card to my hand. End of turn, I might just take a Tranquil Ticket. So that I can sacrifice it again, and then just start drawing cards with a Vran 6. That is going to be my engine for this game. Tranquil the Gut. Mm-hmm. So yeah, let's do this. I'll get a... I don't know, do we have a Greenland? Tag and buy your deer? Alright, then I'll get a forest. And I'll pass. I'm 12 already. Because of the Ancient Tomb and Shocklands and such. Opponent looks like they are really hurt by the Chalice of the Void. Uh-huh. Alright, let's cycle. Looks diamond. Sure. Let's play it. Now let's play a land and pass the turn. Kinda wanna just keep on I don't know, just getting a bunch of different lands out. Probably just sacrificing this ancient tomb. Cause I don't need more ramping. Getting, Ghost Quarter. The Discover End Size, and I can... Grazebrand, ooh. Alright, that was a good draw then, if it was Grazebrand. Take the Tranquil Ticket. And then I will play Zenith. for two. And I will get an ooze. Maybe this deck should play Bazooka Bog. Wonder why it isn't. Alright, they concede to the ooze? Yes. Alright. So, let's get Leyland of the Void in. And maybe just sideboard out a bunch of clunky cards. Like Mren, Vren, Ramunap. And, I don't know, Abrupt Decay? I guess, let's go with this. Maybe we want Maelstrom Pulse, because that can kill a 7-7, but I'll very likely just die if they do that. Maybe they have, like, some weird things. Is there any other random creatures that I want to cut? They're very unlikely to take, yeah, probably just not the Master. I'll still keep Titania, but yeah, let's go with this. Alright, I think I'm going to easily mulligan this hand. While, sure, you know, you can play some things, but I think the matchup will be about... Yeah, just... I mean, like, all these hands are playable, but I don't think I can ever beat Reanimator, who keeps 7. I'm going to put two cards to the bottom here. I'm definitely taking Caracas. Sorry, keeping the Caracas. I think I'll bottom a Swamp and an Abrupt Decay. Maybe not. Maybe just these two. Yeah, maybe just these two. Leyland's in. Now, I have my Caracas, I have my Cinema Library, I have all my colored mana. Alright, they have an island. Alright. Mm-hmm. Next turn, best draw would be maybe Chalice. I think I can go Library, you know? Alright, I'll just open the Exile Zone only. My graveyard will be here, their graveyard will be here, but it's none, and this is the Exile Pile. They can also go Show and Tell, because they play blue, so it could be one of those, like, Reanimator blue and black that has access to Show and Tell plus sideboard. I don't really know what I was playing against, but we did see Grazer Brand, you know? That should tell a lot. Oh wait, I just realized it could be also Sneak and Show. I just realized that. Alright, no, there aren't. Okay, draw Leyline. This deck can't cast Leyline though, so it's not like a super dead card. They very likely have like a Chain of Vapor or Echoing Truth to deal with it. Let's see if they have Daze. If they have Daze is very annoying because like this is all library is all I got. Basically, but they don't know it. They do not know it. Alright, that resolves. As if they just play Entomb just to shuffle the top of the deck. They don't. And they just redraw the cards that they put on top. Mm-hmm. Petal. And Show and Tell, I guess. I'm gonna play Caracas here. Iona, nice. Iona, in green, sure, I got my Caracas out. And they can see the game. Very nice. 5-1 losing to the one and only JPA. And yeah, that's it. The deck was fun. I really like it. I really, really like it. Not sure, you know, if it's like the best deck. Like the Trophy Leader does play it a lot, and he does trophy with it a lot. It's definitely something fun that I'm very glad it's on the Legacy Panorama. Any toolbox deck with Zenith, it's fun. Alright, thank you guys for watching. I'll be back for more Legacy videos. Probably just more decks. We play 4 of Random 6 now that I have access to them. And see you next time. If you like the video, please press like on the YouTube channel. And I'll see you next time.